Attendance over. Now I'm sharing the screen.
Yes, ma'am.
Tapun, I can see you. Okay. Let share the screen. Everybody who have entered the class, please give your attendance. And now I'm sharing the screen. So if anybody try to enter the classroom, please don't see. Where is? Can you hear me all? And screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So anyone know what is array? What is array? Suppose till now you have storing the values in a single variable. But now if you want to take together multiple values in a variable, it is not possible, because if I declare int a, then only one value can assign that. But at a time, if I want to assign a variable to multiple values, single variable with multiple values, then we need the array. Array is the groups of similar type of array. What is the definition of array? See, suppose here we are. See, what is the problem with normal programs? Suppose you have declared four variables over here, and if you try to scan the four variables and print the all the variables, then you have to give 5% marks, and then with comma you have to scan ampersand A1, ampersand A2, ampersand A3, ampersand A4, ampersand N5. For this 5% five variables value you can give from the keyboard. And for printing, you also need 5% and the variables. What is the difference between scanf and printf? For scanf, we need an address or ampersand operator to place before every variable, as we are scanning to the address of the variables. And for printf, we don't need any address because we are just putting the values. Here we are placing the values. Here we are putting the values. For placing the values, you need to search the address. But for placing the values, you don't need that. Okay? Now, what is the problem? So instead of doing that, you can make one variable only and can take 5 values. So in that way, array has come. So what is array? Array is a data structure storing a group of elements, all of which are of the same data type. That means either integer array or float array, all the elements of the array share the same name and they are distinguished from one another with the help of an index. Random access to every element using a numeric index. A simple data structure used for decades, which is extremely useful. It is an abstract data type. List is frequently associated with the array data structure. So see how we declare one array. Like we have to declare one character array. Sorry, one integer array. But we have named the array as, what is the notations for declaring array? You have to first give the data type, then you have to give the array name, then in third bracket you have to give the array size. So tell me, in int char size 80, what is the data type of array? Tell me.
Integer.
What is the name of the array? What is the name?
Char.
What is the size of the array?
80.
Suppose the, how many values you can store in that array? How many integers? Tell me how many integers you can store.
80, ma'am.
80. But each box will have an address. That address will be started from 0. See the thing. Array is homogeneous in nature. Why? Because array contains same type of variable. If you are declared as int, then you have only position int inside the arrays. No float, no stat, no char is allowed in this array. Here, only the floating point numbers are allowed. Here, character variables are only allowed. The amount of storage for a declared array has to be specified at compile time. So tell me, why array is, it is array is static or array is dynamic? Tell me. It is a static data structure or it is a dynamic data structure? It is a static.
Ma'am, what is static data structure and dynamic data structure?
Yes. You have pre-initialized the size of the array. So it is a static. You cannot change the size of the array in runtime. That's why it is a static data structure. If you can change the size at runtime, then it will be a dynamic data structure. In this C programming, in this second sim or first sim, with C programming, dynamic data structures are not in syllabus. Dynamic data structures like stack, array, linked list, these are all in stack, queue, linked list, these are all included in your data structure course code. That is not in this semester. So here you have learned only the static data structure. Why it is a static data structure? Why it is called data structure? Data structure are those in which we can store the data. Okay. And we use the array to store the data. So array is a data structure and it is a static data structure. Why? Once you declare char int char 80, what is the size of 1 int 2 byte? So 80 into 2 byte, 160 byte will be allocated from memory for this data structure. Okay, so ki hocche pre-occupation of memory as the size is declared. This, suppose you have declared the size 80, but you have given only 40 values. So the other 40 places will be vacated and wasted. So this is the disadvantage of array, because as you have prefixed the size of the array, so you have, if you are giving all the all the positions of value, then okay. But if some of the positions are being vacated out of 80, if you give only 40 values, then it is not a proper array. Okay. Hash define size 5. MCA students know what is hash define, but BCA students, I have not taken any class for hash define. But in the first day, I told you about hash preprocessor directives. If you define hash define, this directive in top of the program can be written. It is used to give value to particular variable. So as you are defining size 5, so in the program, wherever you use the variable size, it will have the value of 5. Hash define size 5. Take it in mind. Now see, we are taking one loop variable int I equals to 0. Int, what is that? Now this line you please see. Tell me what is the data type of array, what is the name of the array, and what is the size of the array. Tell me. From this line, you tell me what is the name of the array, what is the array?
Start marks.
What is the data type of the array?
Int.
What is the size of the array?
It's 5.
Understood? Because we already defined size as 5. There is a loop variable. See, why you use for loop, that you should know. See, here you have declared 5 variables. For scanf, you need 5% D. For printf, you need 5% D. So it is not a good way of program, because if what you are declaring 5 variables, you should have. But if I declare here 20 variables, then it is possible to write 20 times scanf percent D, 20 times percent D in printf. It is not a good programming approach. So we combined all the variable in a single array. You are declared here 5 variables to give 5 different values. Instead of that, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, you have declared here the array start marks.
Ma'am, onake join korte jacche.
কেউ জয়েন করবে now. Now array will move from 0 to less than size i++. So instead of a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, you have given one array start marks whose size is 5. So instead of writing 5 times percent D, you write here only 1 time percent D. Printf element number equal to percent D comma I plus 1. Can you tell me why we have not denoted here I? We have denoted here I plus 1. What is the initial size of array? Tell me.
Zero.
So size if 5, then the array have 5 positions. Start marks 0, start marks 1, start marks 2, start marks 3, start marks 4. In start marks 0, the value will be the value at position 0. So that was size mane ki, total array size. Kintu ekta jinish you have to remind that if you declared one array, then correspondingly if you declare some indexes also. Suppose size is an array, it is a box of variables, 5 boxes are there, and each of the box will have some index. The first room is having index 0, the second room is having index 1, the third room is having index 2. Otherwise tumi bolo naam to ektai, ami jodi 5 ta value di, if I give 5 values, how can I identify that which value actually we want? But if I tell you, acha eta dekhe nao, age ota bolchi ami aschi, স্ক্যান করছো ভ্যালু, কটা পার্সেন্টে দিয়েছো, আই একটা, এবং কি লিখছো, আই প্লাস ওয়ান, আই কেন প্লাস ওয়ান, সো প্রিন্ট এফ এলিমেন্ট নাম্বার ইফ আই রিটার্ন হিয়ার ইকুয়াল টু পার্সেন্টে কমা আই প্লাস ওয়ান ফর দ্য ফার্স্ট ইটারেশন অফ লুপ, হোয়াট উইল বি প্রিন্টেড, এলিমেন্ট নাম্বার ইকুয়াল টু হাউ মাচ উইল বি প্রিন্টেড, বলো আই এর ইনিশিয়াল ভ্যালু কত, 0 0 1, সো এলিমেন্ট নাম্বার 1, এলিমেন্ট নাম্বার 1 আই প্লাস 1, ইউ আর প্রিন্টিং আই প্লাস 1 বিকজ দিস ইনডেক্স ইজ 0 বাট দ্য নাম্বার ইজ 1, সো তুমি যদি আমি বলি 0th এলিমেন্ট ইট উইল নট হিয়ার নাইস, সো ফর প্রোগ্রামিং ফর্মালিটি ই হ্যাভ ইফ উই গিভ ইয়ার 0 then we increment the I plus 1. So in first iteration it will print element number equals to 1. Then it will print enter the value of element. Then what we have done here, scanf %d and stud marks in third bracket I. What is the meaning of third, inside third bracket we have declared I. What is the meaning of I?
Position of the array element.
It is the zeroth element. Start and mark 0. So, 0 position e koto jabe? Suppose you have given 11 over here. So, start mark 0 will have 11. Now, again we will loop the move. I equals to the new value of how much? 1. It is less than size. 1 is less than 5. So, it will come here. Yes, and every number will be printed as 1 plus 1, 2. So element number is printed as 2. Enter the value of element, scanf, %d, ampersand star marks, it will be, কি হবে, 2 হবে না 1 হবে, কি হবে বলো তো? এই লেখাটার জন্য শুধু I plus 1 করছি, I এর ভ্যালুটা কিন্তু 0, মানে 1, মানে যেটা এখানে আছে ওটাই থাকবে. In first iteration, it will be 0. So star marks 0 is 11. Then in second position, it will be 1. So start marks 1 will be 12. In third position, it will be 2. So start marks 2 equals to 13. Start marks 3 and start marks 4. After that, when 4 plus plus be there, it will be 5 and it will not less than 5. 5 is not less than 5. Condition will not match and the program will end. তাহলে আমি এই আমাকে একটু বলো তো, আমি এই লুপটা চালিয়ে যতটা আমি ইয়ে করছি, আমি কি করলাম এই লুপটা চালিয়ে? প্লিজ আমার
ভ্যালু গুলোকে ইনপুট দিলাম,
ভ্যালু গুলোকে ইনপুট দিলাম, ওকে, নরমাল ভ্যালুর সঙ্গে এই ভ্যালু যে আমি স্ক্যান করছি, ডিফারেন্স কি, হোয়ার ইজ দ্য ডিফারেন্স ফ্রম স্ক্যানিং আ সিঙ্গেল ভ্যারিয়েবল এন্ড স্ক্যান, tell me the difference, what is the difference, normal valuable hole ki third bracket er moddhe I ta asto asto na, loop ta koto bar move korche ekhane, size of the array, that much time the loop is moving, what is the actually array class na, online nawa jay na, এরকম ভাবে হয় না, ওটা বোর্ডে করে দেখাতে হয়, ঠিক আছে? ইট ইজ ভেরি ডিফিকাল্ট টু টেক অনলাইন ক্লাস ফর অ্যারে, ফর আই ইকুয়ালস টু জিরো অ্যান্ড দ্য ইফ দেয়ার আর সাইজ ইকুয়ালস টু ফাইভ, সো হাউ মেনি এলিমেন্টস উইল বি দেয়ার? Five elements, but five elements will have the ith value is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you tell start marks 3, tell me from the output, what is the value of third position, sir? আচ্ছা, আমি তো বলে যাচ্ছি অনেকক্ষণ ধরে, কার কোথায় অসুবিধা হচ্ছে একটু বলো তো, আমি বলে যাচ্ছি তোমরা বুঝতে পারছো না, একটু বলো তো কোথায় অসুবিধাটা হচ্ছে, তাহলে আমি সেইভাবে বোঝাবো। তো বেসিক জিনিসটাই যদি না বোঝো তাহলে আর এগিয়ে গিয়ে কি লাভ, বলো কোথায় অসুবিধা হচ্ছে?
না ম্যাম, বুঝতে পারছি।
বুঝতে পারছো?
হুম হুম
সবাই কি বুঝতে পারছে?
হ্যাঁ
বুঝতে
ম্যাম।
কে বললে, নামটা বলো তো।
আমি ইন্টারেস্টেড এমসিএ।
এমসিএ রা তো বুঝতে পারবে, বিসিএ রা কি বুঝতে পারছে? এমসিএ দের তো ফাইল অবধি হয়ে গেছে,
ওই জন্য চুপ করে আছি ম্যাম।
কিছু করার নেই তো, তোমরা তো এই বইটা পড়াইনি, তোমাদের তো ওদের জন্য
হ্যাঁ
পড়া। দেখো আমি একটা কথা বলছি, ফর বিসিএ স্টুডেন্ট ইউ হ্যাভ ডিক্লেয়ার্ড দ্য ভেরিয়েবল অ্যাজ স্টুড আন্ডারস্কোর মার্কস অ্যারে, হোয়াট ইজ দ্য সাইজ? ফাইভ। সো ইট উইল হ্যাভ বক্স অফ রুমস অ্যান্ড how can you access each of the room, the access you have to, if you give the size 5, then how many variables you can give? Start marks in position 0, start marks in position 1, start marks in position 2, start marks in position 3, and start marks in position 4. 0, 1, 2,
Ma'am.
3. Follow.
Ma'am means n minus 1, n minus 1.
Yes, n minus 1. N minus is 1.
Hello?
N
ma'am, size.
Haan, bolo. Shunchi.
Ma'am, jitna size define karte hain, uska minus 1 hota leta hai wo.
Haan, kyun hota hai? Kyunki hum log start kis se kar rahe hain? Zero se. To kitna sa?
Zero se.
Kya kya position create hoga? Zero, one, two, three, four.
Two, three. Up to n.
ठीक है, अभी कितना वैल्यू हुआ? जीरो, वन, टू, थ्री, फोर, पांच वैल्यू हुआ। सो कितने जा रहे हो? सी से लेस देन फाइव तक। तो पहले आएगा कौन? स्टार्ट मार्क जीरो, सिलेक्ट द नंबर, इट विल बी प्लेस हियर, देन हु विल कम? स्टार्ट मार्क्स वन, सो इन द वन पोजीशन यू टेक अनदर वैल्यू, देन टू, देन थ्री, देन फोर, सो सी द आउटपुट एलिमेंट। एलिमेंट तुम एटा जो तुम जीरो दाओ ना, if you give this thing percent i, then no issue, but it will print it, what the change will be obtained? It will print it element number 0, element number 1, element number 2, element number 3, element number 4. But this is not a good approach to write a program, because element number 0 is not a good approach. So what we have made, we have done single change, we have instead of 0 we have 1, okay? And then entering the value of element, scaling the value of element. How many times this I will change? Tell me. How many times this I will change?
Five times.
And the position will change 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And what are the value given in, what is the value of start mark 0? Tell me from the, what is the value of the start?
11.
11.
Start marks 1, 12. Start marks 2, 13. 12. Start marks 3, 14. Start marks 4, 15. See? Following are the values stored in the corresponding array elements. When you have given 0th position, it is 11. 1 position, it is 12. 2 position, it is 13. 4th position is 14. And 4th position is 15. Because it is only I plus 1 leakage for better programming in efficiency. Who are coming and going? See how many students. Please all give your attendance.
Ma'am, give in.
Okay. No, I have ask for the newcomers who are joining at 2:40. In previous program, we have given how you can scan the array elements. But here you can see directly we can give the value. User, if you don't want to take the value, directly you can put the value. What is the data type of the array? Tell me. Int.
Integer.
The name of the array? Digits. What is the size of the array? 10. So how long the how many positions is created? 0 to 9. And equal to, if you put a 10 value inside the braces, so array is declared as well as is initialized. Now, any one of you tell me what is the value of digit and in third position 4. What is the value? Tell me. Digit, third position 4. Means inside bracket we have written digits 4. Then what will be the result?
5.
So 1 is at its 0 position, 2 is at 1 position, 3 it has 2 position, 4 is at third position. Sorry, fourth position, and 5 is at fifth position. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So inside under 5 is the fourth position because we have started the position from 0. If I told digits 0, it is equals to 1. Digits 1 equal to 2. Digits 2 equals to 3. Digits 3 equals to 4. Digits 4 equals to 5. And if I ask digits 9, how much it will be? Understood. It is character array. Char thing 3. Oh, one thing I have. You can write this line as well as this line. Why? You declared the size as 10 and given 10 values. And if you given the value of 10 values already you have given, don't it? The mentioning of size is not required. These are the different way of declaring the values with different data types. Arrays with different.
Ma'am, what will happen if we will not mention the size?
Nothing will happen. If you see this portion is not there and you have not mentioned the size, then it will be invalid. But this portion is there and you are not mentioning the size, it is valid. But if this portion means this initialized, the array is not initialized, then you must have to give the size. But if you have already given the values, you don't need to take the values from user. Then we can already see that there are 10 values. So automatically is understood that digits is of size 10. And though it can be, this is a accepted representation. If you given the value, then if you're not depicting the size over here, then it is accepted. See, float temperature 10 given this values. Float double width, no size has given. We can see that there are how many values? There are 4 values. 4, I think. Like 3 here. So zeroth position will this much, first position is this much, and second position is this much. This is the way to declare character array. Char thing 3. How many values it will take? 3. What will be the position? Char thing 0 is equals to T, char thing 1 equals to Y, and char thing 2 equals to N. See how we declaring, what is the difference between the declaring the integer array and the character array? In integers, we have not created any single quote. But in character, we have to give the single quote to understand that they are characters. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
See this one. Here we have size specified 4, but given 3 numbers. Whereas the second one is a 4-character string. Because if generally, if it is a string, see একটা জিনিস তুমি জানবে, ক্যারেক্টার অ্যারে মানে হচ্ছে ইউ হ্যাভ টু প্লেস বাই সিঙ্গেল কোট, এন্ড স্ট্রিং মিন্স ইট ইজ আট উই হ্যাভ টু প্লেস ইট বাই ডবল কোট, সিঙ্গেল কোট অ্যান্ড ডবল কোট, সো ইট ইজ নট আ ক্যারেক্টার অ্যারে, ইট ইজ আ স্ট্রিং. When we are placing each of the variable with a particular single quote, then it's a character array. But here we have specified the size and given only three characters in a single quote. That means it is also occupying four places. But as it is string, always there would be an end character which is known as slash zero, null character. And so we have specified the character array size as so character array will take only characters when the characters are given by single quote, but same character array will take a string, that is a group of characters, when they are given by the double quotes. And when character array contain characters, there is no slash zero character, but when the character array contain a group of different lines, words, etake space diye tumi onek kotha likhe, you can make it a big paragraph. For that you have to increase the size, but each the last character of an string will be slash zero. Slash zero char thing e thake na, eta shudhu character array ba string ei thake. How can you differentiate an character array? If you put single quote over each of the variable, then it is a character array. If you put double quotes, then it is not a character array, it will be a string. Subscript. What is the program? Program to find the maximum marks among the marks of 10 students. See, separately giving, declaring 10 variables, separately scanning 10 marks, and separately finding the marks. It is very difficult. So we have taken one array whose name is stud marks. How many marks it will take? No, it will take the marks for 10 students. So the size is 10. Now we require one loop variable initialized with zero, and one max variable that is also initialized with zero. Now we move the loop. The loop will move the size of times. So I equals to zero, I less than size, I plus plus. Each time it will print the student number, and by formality instead of I, it will give I plus one. Now enter the marks out of 50. So in first iteration of loop, it will give the marks from for the zeroth student. And how many times the loop will move? Chen, tell me. This loop will move how many times? And how many marks it will add up?
10.
10 ki? No. Yes. One second. What is the size? Yes, it will. So there is a wastage of array or not in this program? The array defined as size, maximum size. Size is 10.
Okay.
No. The max size is size. So it will move for 10 times. The first ith value will be 0. Start marks 0 will be the marks of the first student. Start marks 1 will be the marks of the second student. And this way from 0 to 9, and marks of 10 students will be accepted. Similarly, now you have to check the which marks is the maximum marks. Now you have all the marks, you have taken all the marks from keyboard. Now you have to check the maximum. For checking, you need to run the same loop, because each of the mark is going to check with the max variable to find out of whom is the highest mark. So for checking, we have run this loop. For I equals to 0, I less than size, I plus plus. If start marks I greater than max, max equals to start marks I. If anyone can explain this part, can explain me, then I will explain. It is the comparison with the max variable and finding out the maximum of the array marks. এমসিএ বলতে পারো, অসুবিধা নেই।
ম্যাম আমরা চেক করছি যে আমাদের কারেন্ট যে অ্যারে পজিশনে ভ্যালুটা আছে সেটা আমাদের ম্যাক্স ভ্যালুর সঙ্গে
বেশি আছে কি,
ম্যাক্স কে কত দিয়ে ইনিশিয়াল, হাউ মাচ with which value we have initialized the max variable, with which value?
I'm zero.
So suppose ধরো তুমি একটু নিচের আউটপুটটা দেখো, what are the 10 marks we have taken? We have taken 10, 17, 23, 49, 34, 37, 16, I, 8, 37. The loop will move for 10 times and this marks are taken. So what will happen? First marks is how much? 10. See, so what will happen? Start marks 0 is greater than max. Start marks 0 is how much? 10. 10 is greater than max.
10.
Then max equals to start marks 0. Then the new max will be 10. Now it takes 17. Because your counter is incremented by 1. I is now new value 1. And your max is now 10. So start marks 1 will be how much? 17. Is 17 greater than the older max value? That is 10. Yes. Yeah. 7 greater than 10. Then max equals to the new marks. Start marks 1. That is 17. Seven. Now max value kato? 17. Now you take 23. So to start marks I means 23 is greater than 17. Yes. Then max equals to 23. Then you take 40 and 49, and similarly the final marks will be, final maximum marks will be 49. Now again you check with 34, then what will happen? Suppose max equals to 49, then what will happen? I plus plus, the I plus plus one is 0 1 2 3 4 5. Now when start marks 5 e jabe, start marks 5 e jabe, তখন কি হবে? এটা চেক করা হবে ম্যাক্সের সাথে, যদি এটা ম্যাক্সের থেকে বড় হয় তো হোয়াট উই আর স্ক্যানিং, স্টার্ট মার্কস 5 ইজ 34, ইজ 34 গ্রেটার দেন 49? ইজ নো, সো দিস লাইন উইল নট বি অ্যাকসেপ্টেড। তা আমাকে কি চেক করতে হবে? যে আমি স্টুডেন্ট মার্কস এখানে 0 1 2 3 বসাবো, 0 জন্য 10 বসাবো, 1 এর জন্য 1 বসাবো, 2 এর জন্য 2 বসাবো, 3 এর জন্য 3 বসাবো, 4 এর জন্য 4 বসিয়ে প্রত্যেকটা নাম্বারকে লাস্ট ম্যাক্সের সাথে চেক করব। যদি আমার নাম্বারটা ম্যাক্সের থেকে বড় হয় তাহলে নিউ ম্যাক্স উইল বি দিস ওয়ান। সো হোয়াট 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 উই হ্যাভ টু ডু, ফর ইচ ইটারেশন উই হ্যাভ টু প্লেস স্টার্ট মার্কস 0 দ্যাট ইজ 10 এন্ড কম্পেয়ার উইথ দ্য current max, it is 0. 10 is greater than 0. So max equals to 10. Now the second iteration, 10 is 7, the new marks is 17. 17 greater than 10. So max equals to 17. Then for the second 2, I equals to 2. So 23 is greater than 17. So max equals to 23. I equals to 3. Then 40 will be greater than 17. Now 23. So 40 is the maximum. Then 49, it will be the maximum. But in after that one iteration will come, when I's value is 5, then we have found that start marks 5 equals to 34. And 34 is not greater than 49. So that if this line will not be executed and the last max will be the max, which is 49. Again, you are comparing with 37. 37 will not be accepted. 16 will not be accepted because all are less than the max. So finally, 37, 8, all are unexpected. So the final max value is 49 and it will print, it will close the loop, it will close the loop here, close the loop by 10 times repetition, checking the number with the max to check if the number is greater than max, then max will be the number. But if it, the number is not greater than max, then you go to the next. And finally, outside of loop, you come and you print whatever is placed in the max. Max is having maximum variable and you are placing here percent max. Corresponding I also, you can, ei I ta koto hobe? Ei I ta hobe max 49 mane koto te chilo? The maximum of the marks obtained among percent D comma max percent d comma max of 10 student is 49. এটা বোঝা গেল?
Yes ma'am.
See this program. If you have any doubt, you can tell me. It is problem to display the average marks of 3 students. If you have any doubt to number. I'm giving 1 minute break. Please, you go through this problem. Then ask me what is the problem with it. Tell me who is going to explain the program. Any one of you please explain.
Ma'am, first of all, in the first array, stud marks 1, there is no underscore.
Well, I think it is a printing mistake. Don't worry. It is a printing mistake. It goes to with your IGNU books. Next. How many arrays we have declared?
4 arrays.
4. Acha. First array is taking what?
The marks of student 1.
The second array is taking the marks of student 2. And the third array is taking the marks of student 3. Okay? So, marks 1.
Ma'am, first term marks first subject and second term marks of second subject. Dutu subject bolata hai. At inter student acha.
So for each subject, there is one array. Enter the marks in subject 1 out of 50 marks. So how many marks you will give for subject? What is the size of it?
3.
3. For subject 1, there are 3 students. So there will be 3 marks. So suppose you 3 students, all of you need to give your marks in, suppose, computer science. So this marks will contain the marks of computer science of 3 students. This will take the marks of maths of 3 students. Now, ei dure to bojha gelo ekhane kichu nei ei eki jinish. I will be the loop variable and start mark size are the positions are index. So how many loop you have already run? We have run 2 loops for scanning variable. Now you have to find out the total marks. Total marks I equals to stud marks I plus stud marks 1I plus stud marks 2I. So what will happen? So total marks you are in a is a new array whose zeroth position will contain the value at the zeroth position of the starred marks 1 and value of the zeroth position of the starred marks 2. So there are two arrays. There are two arrays. First array will have student number 1 and its marks are 1. Student number 1 can reach. One second. Yes, student number 1, 2, 3. Okay. So when it will move, it will print like that. Student number 1, enter marks. Suppose entering the marks 23. Then for the same loop, it will be student number 2 and the marks is 35. And for third student, the marks is 42. Then this array will be closed. And the second array will run. Now also student number 1, 2, 3. And for 1, there will be a marks. For 2, there will be a marks. And for 3, there will be a marks. So first array contains 3 marks. Second array contains 3 marks. So in the total array, what will happen? For 3 students, you have to give the total marks. So 23 will be added to 31, 35 to be added to 35, and 42 to be added to 40. So it will be the total marks. So total marks 0 equals to starred marks 0 plus starred marks 2, 0. Total marks 1 equals to starred marks 1 plus starred marks 2, 1. So এটা দেখো যখন তুমি টোটাল মার্কস জিরো করছো তখন বাট স্টার্ট মার্কস জিরো উইল বি 23 অ্যান্ড স্টার্ট মার্কস টু উইল বি 31 নাও ফর দ্য নেক্সট ইটারেশন সো দ্য হোয়াট উইল বি সো হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য আনসার For the total marks zeroth position will be student marks 1 zero position plus student marks 2 zero position. আমাকে এখান থেকে বলো তো দুটো সাবজেক্টের জিরোথ পজিশনে কি কি মার্কস আছে
23 আর 31
So here will be 23 and here will be 31 and total marks 0 will be how much
54
Then for the second iteration it will be 35 and 35 so it will be 30 And 70 and last one is 82. But we are not printing the total, we are just calculating the total, and for each time we are dividing it by 2. And that value will move into AVGI. All are array. So the zeroth position will contain the average mark of the first student, and the one position of this average array will contain the average marks of the second student. Total marks K, why we divide by 2? Why we divide total marks by 2?
ম্যাডাম টোটাল নাম্বার স্টুডেন্টস তো দুটো আছে আর
টোটাল নাম্বার স্টুডেন্টস আছে তিনটে টোটাল নাম্বার স্টুডেন্টস আছে তিনটে আমরা কিন্তু এই আইফানে ফর ইচ স্টুডেন্টের জন্য করছি বোঝার চেষ্টা করো টোটাল নাম্বার স্টুডেন্টস আছে তিনটে বাট উই আর নট এভারেজিং দ্য স্টুডেন্টস উই আর এভারেজিং দ্য মার্কস ও
হ্যাঁ
ইচ স্টুডেন্ট হাউ মেনি মার্কস আর देयर টু মার্কস থ্রি মার্কস Three marks now. This is the marks for student 1, student 2, and student 3. Again, this is the marks for 31, 35, 30. So, first student is having the marks of 23 and 31. So, two marks. For each student, there are two marks. And that two marks are 23 plus 31 by 2. So, this will be the average. The next iteration, it will be 35 plus 35 by 2. And the third iteration will be 42 plus 40 by 2. Okay, so this way we are finally we are printing the average student number equals to percent D and we are printing the average equals to percent F and comma the student number ke I plus 1 kolam or average ke AVGI kolam. See, first you have to read, then you can only understand. And it is my last program because I think it will be overfitted then. See, the linear search program and it is generally come in your exams, see the linear search programs, enter any 5 members. So from the array is named as list, num list, and from 0 to 5 times it will run, and each time it will take a new value. Each time it will take a new value. So this nameless array will have total 5 values. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of linear search? Linear search means first you have to fade an array with some number of values. Then you will try to search another variable whether it is present in the array or not. What is linear search? You have to linearly or sequentially search. You have to first search the zeroth position, whether the zeroth position element and the element you are searching for are same or not. Then you have to find the second position. And when you are getting the matching that the searching element and the searched element are same, then the program will be break from the loop. So for I equals to 0, I less than size, I plus plus, printf element number percent %d value of element I plus 1, scanf percent %d ampersand numlist I, enter the element to be searched, scanf percent %d and ampersand j. Now, what will happen that which array you have to search? Numlist. How many values it have? No size, that is 5 values. What element you have to match? No, j. So you have to find out whether this j element is present in the list or not. For what? For that, what you have to do? Again, you have to move the loop for I equals to 0, I less than size, I plus plus. If j equal to, you have to come if j equal to numlist I. Suppose for first it will be numlist 0. See the output, you enter any 5 numbers. These are the 5 numbers. Enter the element to be searched, 8. So you have to search 8. So 8 is the value of j. Numlist 0 is 23. Numlist 1 equals to 43. Numlist 2 equals to 12. Numlist 3 equals to 8. And numlist 3, 4 equals to 5. The 5 elements. And you have to search that whether this element is here. But we directly korte paro na. Direct search is not possible. You have to first search the zeroth position. If j equals to numlist 0, no, then again the loop will move. I equals to plus plus, and you come here. J equal to numlist 1, no. Again go here. I equals to 2. J equals to numlist 2, yes, no. Keno ki dekho? এটা জিরোথ এলিমেন্ট, একটা ওয়ান, এটা টু, একটাও কিন্তু এইট নয়। নাও কাম আই ইকুয়ালস টু থ্রি, সো নামলিস থ্রি ইকুয়ালস জে, ইফ জে ইকুয়ালস টু নামলিস থ্রি, হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জে? দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জে ইজ এইট, অ্যান্ড নামলিস থ্রি, জিরো ওয়ান টু থ্রি, দ্যাট ইজ অলসো এইট, সো ম্যাচড, অ্যান্ড দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু প্রিন্ট, ওয়ান্স ইট ম্যাচ দেন ইউ প্রিন্ট, দ্য পজিশন ইজ পার্সেন্ট ডি কমা দ্য সরি দ্য নাম, ইউ ইউ আর নট printing the number, you are only printing the position. So what is the position? 0, 1, 2, 3. But will that be printed? No, it will print at the fourth position because I have given here I plus 1. And then break and the program completes. Hey, to go away, share corner job and I don't matter. I never know me. They see for a class.
Ma'am, somewhere it is given scanf percentage D and scanf percentage. What is the difference?
Tell which line you tell me?
Ma'am, above.
Above konta eta?
No, ma'am, somewhere it is given a scanf percentage f or some scanf percentage d. What is the difference between scanf percentage d and scanf?
If you are scanning the variable integer, then it is percent d. If you are the scanning the variable that is float, then it will be, you have to use percent f. No, no,
okay,
not
thank you.
Other distance. Okay, stop.
Okay, thank you.
ম্যাম ম্যাম বলছিলাম আমাদের কোনো প্র্যাকটিক্যাল রিলেটেড খবর আপনার কাছে?
হ্যাঁ আমি বলছি, আমি দেখছি, আমি আমার মনে হয় না নেই, মনে হয় আছে। ওয়ান সেকেন্ড, আই হ্যাভ টু স্টপ দ্য রেকর্ডিং। না, প্র্যাকটিক্যাল রিলেটেড খবর আমার নেই।